HR. We would like to see today the process flow of HR SOPs of recruitments. That is the recruitment process flow. From manpower requisition format up to the offer sending process, which we'll try to cover into the recruitment process flow today. So these are only two important stages that we are going to consider. It is right from MRF, that is the manpower requisition form, up to the sending of an offer stage. So this is a step-by-step recruitment SOP, which will help you in terms of the day-to-day activities of HR. Step into C, we'd like to understand the entire process flow, a step-by-step approach. To start with a manpower requisition, that is a requisition given by an HOD or an initiator, which will try to cover in terms of the job profile of a particular position, whether it is a new position or a replacement position, what is the CTC or a budget for that particular position, and the other attributes of the credential which will require to suffice to the particular position. We would like to cover in this the MRF form. I'll show you the snapshot of that as well. The next step would be the form is received by an HR. HR will start with an sources of recruitment, that is internal, external, both, or the other medium of sources in terms of the getting the appropriate CVs. Prior to that, we would like to do a competency mapping in terms of the desired profile as well as an existing profile. And proceed ahead with the CV shortlisting process. Normally, we try to create a database with respect to the recruitment. So, I'd like to cover the further steps in terms of the scheduling process, the different types of round or a test of an interview process. Might be a face-to-face or a telephonic or a test, aptitude test or a specific test with respect to a particular position. Based on the test results and the interview process, we will arrive at a decision, so which we call it as an interview assessment. The final and the further round must be taken of interview feedback, which we call it as an assessment. And further to that, if we finalize a particular candidate, we would like to go ahead in terms of the reference check of a particular person. So I'd like to cover here as well as a reference check as well. The further CTC finalization, we would like to see in terms of the what is offered particular CTC with the budgeted part. Is there any differentiation or any difference in it? And would like to cover as that as well. So offer has been given to the candidate. The next step would be acceptance on an offer. So up to the complete follow-up by an HR. And this will end up with the process. So always we need to update our database with reference to the recruitment part. From the further or a final part of an interview, reference check of a particular candidate, as well as a finalized CTC part. An SOP of a recruitment, it is completely an picture format, which you can see it out here. So this starts up to the end process, which we have already covered into the previous slides. The next part would be a different forms. In that, we would like to cover the manpower requisition form. So an initiator on an HOD will give this particular filled up form to the HR so that the further recruitment process can be started off. This would be covering the parts like job profile, the a department or a designation, the position reports to whom, what is the location of a particular position, or a functional or a level wise differentiation, what is the CTC need to be offered, whether it is in sync or out sync with the budgeted part, is it a new position or a replacement position, and the final approval part by the respective management team. Candidates for an interview process, we normally try to go ahead with the interview application blank along with a CV or a resume of a particular person. So this will try to cover the uniformity of the data of a particular prospective candidates, those who are coming for an interview. application blank, the page one and the page two. The next part would be interview assessment sheet. Here we would like to cover the interview assessment based on to the certain criteria. This is with respect to the particular position and the profile or a level wise position, and having an finalized approach in terms of what is the final CTC has been offered and the approval on that. The next part would be, I have tried to cover here the a small reference check example. Normally we try to do a reference check of a particular candidate prior sending any offer letter. So this might be through an email conversation or a telephonic conversation, and this is what the data has been extracted from that particular chat or a conversation part. And this is how we normally try to send the whatever the extracted information to the concerned authorities, so that the further final decision can be taken up accordingly. And practical timeline which I have tried to show out here, it is right from manpower requisition form up to the sending of an offer. So it is practically around 6 to 7 days, and from the offer sending or an acceptance of an offer up to the joining, I have considered approx 25 to 30 days, which is normally a notice period in terms of the experienced people. So roughly we should initiate within a day's time and need to complete within a 6 days time, right from requisition received up to the offer sending process. This is how that we have tried to cover today the recruitment SOP. Hope you have liked that. Requesting all of you to comment on it. Thank you.